Where are you going?
I'm going out scavenging. Don't worry. I'm past thinking about running away. Knowing how much you'd miss me made me not want to leave.
Where's Patrick?
He's getting ready. I'm taking him with me. I figure it's time for him to see what's out there.
Is everything okay? You seem far away.
Nothing can get past you, can it? I've been thinking about the day we met. I never told you how we really ended up there.
You can tell me anything.
I know I can. That's why you're the first person I'm telling this to. That day, loud hammering woke me up. When I came downstairs, I saw my father nailing the window shut. Through the crack, I saw them coming. Hundreds of metal heads and their red eyes. Even though they're just empty shells, I could feel the hate radiating from them.
What did you do?
I made Patrick stay upstairs and went back to talk to my father. We argued for a minute or two, and I tried to pull him away from the window. He pushed me away. I tried it again, but he shoved me. This time I fell. I didn't recognize him as he was reaching for his shotgun. He said, I shouldn't worry about the machines. They wouldn't hurt us. I don't even remember how. But the gun was already in my hands. I closed my eyes and went someplace else. Didn't even hear the shot. I didn't hear Patrick's steps either.
He saw you?
He did. He was staring at me like I was a stranger. He didn't scream or cry, he just stared. I threw the gun away, grabbed Patrick, and tried not to notice the hole in my father's unmoving chest. As we ran, I could hear them coming, so we found somewhere to hide. Then you came. I wanted to tell someone about all this, but I was afraid to.
I'm glad you did.
I am too. We talk a lot about how heartless the machines are. And I started to think that maybe I was too. I probably would have convinced myself of that if it wasn't for you keeping me sane. Thank you for everything. I never thought I would find a friend in times like these.
Is it true? I can look human now?
Well, what's with the dogs?
They've been like that ever since they...
You're alive!
No time for that. Do whatever it takes to get everyone out of that shelter. Do you understand? They're not safe there.
What? Why? God damn it! What does he mean? Get everyone out of the shelter?
Dr. Mac! Is that you? The Resistance needs your help. Mac! It would be a shame to lose that camera.
Now, why would you do that?
Because we don't have time for this. Come out here. Skynet has developed a new Terminator model, the Infiltrator.
You've seen one already?
We've captured one, and we need your help. Are you there?
How do I know you're not an infiltrator? You've seen them. You know how incredibly lifelike they are, so you should understand my concerns. Head up that hill. If you want me to help you, you have to take a test for me.
Test?
Yes, to determine whether you're a Terminator or not. And be careful, I'm watching you. way to make me think that you're not one of them. Unfortunately for you, I'm not that easily fooled.
We don't have time for any of this. Just tell me where you are. I am not a robot.
Living tissue would make you a cybernetic organism, not a robot. Words have meaning. Conversations between human beings would be a lot easier if we all just trusted each other and understood the deeper meaning of what we said. Keep that in mind during this test.
While now, all 8 of them. Well, I guess with you in there, that makes it 9.
Too bad there's no water in that pool. I'd have you jump in and see if you float. Wait, that's a different test.